HDT is not only detox, it includes the whole homeopathy. I don't like it really, but it is necessary that we call it in the future, and we are busy with it, Ton Jansen HDT homeopathy. And that's necessary because Sankaran, Vitukas, everybody does it that way, so I need to have my name on it. I know everything, or nearly everything, from what Vitukas do, what Sankaran do, the Jan Scholte, Kent, Hearing. I do a great research with what Hahnemann did, so I'm very wide. Cis therapy is a beautiful therapy, but I change it, and it is a lot better now, without aggravations. And the name means cis, complete elimination of the autistic spectrum in general. You cis. Never can say this. If you say that, you must prove it. The most autistic children, I get 80 to 85% better. Some, I get 100% better. And cis says that every autistic patient can 100% cure it, and that's not the truth. They go to the judge, some patients, and tell that they promise to treat 100% and they don't do. And the patients win. So you never Ima. Say that. If you want, you can read this book. This is a start, but a lot of it is only a start and it puts you on the wrong leg. The cis therapy, what Tinus did, there are a lot of mistakes, a lot of aggravations. But it was a beautiful start to understand what we are doing. But it is not the meaning that people suffer from our treatment. Because Hahnemann says, quick, gently, and lasting. And that's what we need. Sometimes we get an aggravation, but when it is a really bad aggravation, it is not the right way. We learn all on school that the aggravations are right, and they are showing that the medicine help you. But when I have a heavy reaction with the patient, then I know I'm wrong. Maybe nearby the solution, but not right in the point where we need to treat. And that's standing in the organon. So I'm very busy to write again the organon, but with the knowledge in now, because Hahnemann has done a very beautiful job, and he has right. But he has the right to say this thing with his knowledge, and in his time, but we know more now. This is what Baron did, research with mouses. First he gave toxins like arsenicum until they nearly died, and then he did research for the urine from the mouses, and there was a little arsenicum into that, but not much. Then I gave different kinds of potentials. First he started with CH7, and then he saw the elimination of the arsenicum in the body goes 11%. And then with CH15, 10%. And he gave the potency several times, and every time he looked what's happened. After four times giving, he saw this percentage. And then he goes to five times, six times, seven times, and he saw there was no release anymore. So that's very interesting. And then he hiked up his potency, and there was nearly nothing left. And then C30, he got only 2%. And because of the detoxification, does not only what is in the body, but also what we have on mind symptoms because of arsenicum, because of mercury and everything, it is allowed to have higher potential. But even then, with the research, we find out that the best thing is to start with 30K with people. And after four time giving, we saw a lower percentage of elimination. It stops on the end with five time. It did not really anything. If we do it too long, we get a proving. And we find out after 3 years working with it that we give a constitutional remedy or universal layer remedy on the Saturday. There is more elimination of the toxins. There is more because of the Saturday remedy. When it is a good, we get more result of the detox. The body is more open for the treatment. And if you can have the attitude that you don't punish or think that the patients do things wrong. I have two patients who said to me, I kill someone. And I never prosecute about it. But I want to tell it to someone. Because now I'm feeling again that I want to kill someone. And I said to them, what's happened in your mind that you will do this? And both of them cry and say, you're not judging me, so I can't tell everything to you. So they tell everything. We are not a judge. We only be open and be free in your mind, so the patient can also be free in his mind. We have only symptoms. You can be a homeopath, but when you have no healer inside of you, then you can do nothing. Start to be a healer. And that's only when you can be in now, not in the past, not in the future. The most important reason the patient comes for is ask them what is the reason for your face. That's the most important issue to treat. But we learned that way that we must be a psychologist. Stop with that. Be clear-minded and listen to the symptoms. And give them the good questions. I work also with Tinus. Tinus was a close friend of me. I start in 1993 with detox therapy. I start by myself and do research, and I met Tinus in 2000 and 2001. We gave together a seminar in my property. And he was a great teacher, very charismatic man. I help him to accept his dying process. With what remedy? Yes, and it works perfectly. He had a whole apotheek in his home, but no aceticum acidum. And it was necessary because he was so sad and angry. I get vinegar out of the kitchen, and I work an hour in his kitchen, and I make a potion for him, and he accepts his dying. And he said, "Tom, will you do my seminar?" There was a seminar two weeks later. I said, "Why, Tinus?" He said, "I'm not able to do it anymore." I say, "I see it. But your colleague, where you work with, see do it." And he says, "See do it with you, I hope, because you are the only one who really understands the inside of the CIS method." And on that seminar, he died on 1 April, in peace, with the children around him and his grandchildren. And that moment, I was walking in the nature, and there was a cow with big horns standing in front of me. It was cold. On that moment, he died. And I asked the cow, "Please let me pass you." And he did, and I go my way.
You mean a cow, or you mean a bull?
Detox method as taught by Tinus as well. You repeat potentials until no further reactions. So sometimes a child was more than half year on one detox. But when you give a diluted homeopathic detox, then it must cure it more quicker. And if you take a higher potential, you give also all the diluted things in between. So it is not necessary to go on that way. You can quicker do the 8-week course, or 4 weeks, or 2 weeks. And when it gives bad aggravation, you stop the course. Because we have heavy aggravations without quickly amelioration, then we have the wrong choice. Not a choice, but we made a wrong decision. And it gives confusion when the patient has not a good schedule, then they do the wrong things. And it is necessary that homeopathic detox is lasting long and forever. How to apply the detox course and when it is necessary. I can see in my practice that 95% of the patients I start with the detox course. Detox course is important, hierarchy, toxins and allopathic medicines. How to use to apply the universal layer, how to implant them, I will tell you. And how implantate the constitutional remedy into HDT method. How to use automolecular support and vitamins, because they are important. How to apply the hierarchy of organs and systems. When we think about HDT, every case where is abusing or use of allopathic medicines, even paracetamol, when the advancing is blocked. We can also use this method when the people recovered and fall back in the old constitution state. When we have a patient who's every time good on, I take example, on causticum. And you give for years, every 3 months, one causticum. It is not good. On the end, the patient can get cancer or other chronic diseases because you are suppressed symptoms. And how many homeopaths do this? A lot of homeopaths in this world. And it's not necessary.
So if a remedy works, but then there is a relapse, this means that there is something else which we should...
There's something else. But sometimes we need to give 3 times to get the good energy. So that's also the reason I take the same example, causticum. I give causticum MK 3 times or 4 times or 5 times, and then a week in between. Or some 3 days.
Once every 3 days.
And when then the problem stops and the patient has no problem, he is cured, then you know you're right. If it is not, he comes back after 3 months with the same complaints, you are wrong. Don't think that you make a mistake. No, you make a mistake if you go on again with the same
homeopathic.
Then it is necessary to take the HDT method so you can do a detox of what is necessary. And if there is the constitutional issue still there and the treatment goes very beautiful and other symptoms go much better, better energy and so on, we can take the headaches from causticum. Then it is allowed to do causticum again after the detox, and it will work forever. So never he use causticum again.
So if you give the detox course, and then some symptoms disappear, but yes. Some are left, then you give again this.
Then I give you again.
And only if it works for 100%, then you stop it or...
No, or you give a detox because there are energy problems, digesting problems or whatever, then remove the blockade and we have open space for the old remedy. Mm-hmm. Don't forget the old remedy, because mostly we see the old remedy who works very good, but because the blockade, it didn't cure forever. Yes. But always we must look again to the new situation. Yes.